So now we will look at so-called history-based predictors, which are trying to do well on things like when we have a not taken, taken, not taken, taken repeating pattern, or something like two not takens followed by a taken, and then again two not takens followed by a taken, etc. Again, it's a repeating pattern that even a two-bit predictor will mispredict the taken branch. So it's one-third mispredicting. And even more complicated pattern-based things. It's important to know that these are really 100% predictable. These are repeating patterns. Once you figure out what the pattern is, the branch becomes 100% predictable. It's just that these branches are not predictable with simple n-bit counters. What we need is a predictor that somehow learns the pattern, really. And then it becomes a very accurate predictor. How do we learn the pattern? Well, we don't just look at what's the majority outcome here. For example, here there is no majority outcome at all. Here, not taken is the majority outcome, but takens happen very frequently. So if we just look at what's the majority behavior, we'll have a lot of mispredictions. What we want to look at is the so-called history of the branch. What were the latest so many outcomes? For example, if we have the not taken, taken, not taken, taken, and so on behavior, let's ignore the first one for now and look at this particular prediction here. What we know is that the previous outcome was not taken, and if we know what the pattern is, then we know that when the branch has been not taken previously, our prediction should be taken. And then here the history says the branch previously was taken, so our prediction should be not taken. And if you're doing it this way, then you will be predicting correctly every single time. So what we need to learn is that under the history of not taken, our decision should be taken. Under the history of taken, our decision should be not taken. Let's now look at this NNT branch. In that case, we have not taken, not taken, taken, not taken, not taken, taken. The history now needs to consider the last two decisions. So when we see not taken, not taken, we should be predicting taken. When we see not taken, taken, as the previous two outcomes, we should be predicting not taken. And when we see taken, not taken, we should be predicting not taken. And then we're back to not taken, not taken history, where we should be predicting taken. So if we consider for different histories, different predictions, then we will train our predictor so that it for this history predicts one outcome, for this history predicts possibly another outcome, for this history predicts a different outcome, and so on. And then this becomes a very predictable branch.